नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है। मैं हूं राहुल और आप देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल नंबर 10 और हम लेकर हाजिर हैं अपना ये विज्ञान का कक्षा 10वीं का लाइव इंटरैक्टिव सेशन लेकर, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड दिस इज द पार्ट 3। वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन एंड लर्न्ड पार्ट 1 एंड 2। इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है हमारे सभी के जीवन में, हम घरों में इस्तेमाल करते हैं और इलेक्ट्रिसिटी से हम ट्रैवल कर सकते हैं, ट्रेन हमारी चलती है, कार्गो आता है, बहुत सारी चीज़ें, हमारी पूरी लाइफ जो है इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पर आधारित है कहीं ना कहीं, किसी न किसी रूप में। वो एक विकास का पथ है जिस पर हमें आगे बढ़ना है, लेकिन उसके लिए हमारी जो ऊर्जा ज़रूरतें हैं उन्हें कैसे पूरा किया जाए, ये सब छोटी छोटी बातें हैं जिसकी ज़रूरतें आप हो सकता है पूरी कर सकते हो आगे चल कर, क्या पता आप कुछ ऐसा करें। तो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी क्यों महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि यहाँ पर आपका कंसेप्ट डेवलपमेंट और जो क्लियरेंस है वो सबसे पहले हो जाएगा। ये क्लास 10th का हमारा जो सेशन है, आप इस वक्त चैनल नंबर 10 पर देख रहे हैं। हमारे साथ एक्सपर्ट हैं इस सेशन को पढ़ाने के लिए। यदि आपके जहन में कोई प्रश्न आता है इलेक्ट्रिसिटी से जुड़ा हुआ, तो यू कैन कॉल अस ऑन आर टोल फ्री नंबर विच इज़ 8800-440-559 और यू कैन सेंड अस एन ईमेल इफ़ यू हैव अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव क्वेश्चन ऑन dth.class10@cieet.nic.in। आई वुड लाइक टू इन्वाइट मिस गौरी रॉय फ्रॉम मैसूरू, शी इज़ आर एक्सपर्ट ऑफ दिस सेशन। गौरी जी नमस्कार एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम।
थैंक यू राहुल, नमस्कार टू ऑल माय डियर व्यूअर्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, a very good afternoon to all of you.
Right, और electricity part 3 आज आप पढ़ाने वाली हैं, तो part 1 और part 2 में कुछ ऐसे laws थे और कुछ ऐसी बातें थी जो हमारे daily life से जुड़ी हुई हैं, तो आज part 3 में हम क्या करने वाले हैं?
That is a continuation of the previous sessions. Mm-hmm. So we'll learn something more about electricity, and today we are going to learn about very important law in electricity that is called as Ohm's law.
Okay.
So today basically we'll concentrate on Ohm's law and we'll learn something more about various what to do when we are having different combination of resistances. So first we'll take up Ohm's law and then we'll learn about combination of resistances.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll start with a quick recapitulation of what we have learned in the previous classes, previous sessions. So in the previous sessions we have learned about that what constitutes electric current, how does electric current flow in a circuit, and what is electric potential, what are the units of electric potential and potential difference, what are the different devices which are used for measuring current and potential difference. So all these things we have learned. Now what are we going to discuss today, that is Ohm's law and combination of resistances, that is in series and parallel. So very quickly our students will come to know about what is resistance in physics. So we come across resistance word in English many times, but what is it in physics, we'll come to know. And that is given, that concept comes from Ohm's law. Ohm's law actually clearly tells about what is the relationship between current, voltage, and how resistance is important in that. So Ohm's law, this was given by a German physicist, George Simon Ohm, 1787 to 1854. Mm-hmm. And in 1827, what he did was that he studied the relationship between the current flowing in a conductor and the potential difference across its ends. So children, you have learned that how, what is responsible for the flow of current in a conductor, and you have also learned that what is potential difference. These two things our students have learned. Now how are these two related? How does the current change when we change the potential difference across the ends of a conductor? Agar main simple words mein ise batau, to agar hum voltage change karte hain to current kaise change hoti hai?
Okay.
So ye to hum sabhi jaise daily life mein experience karte hi hain ki agar hum voltage change karte hain to uske hisab se current ghatti ya badhti hai, लेकिन वो रिलेशनशिप कैसा है, इज इट अ लीनियर रिलेशनशिप, इज इट एन इनवर्स, करंट बढ़ाने से वोल्टेज घटती है या बढ़ती है, तो ये चीज जो है वो जर्मन फिजिसिस्ट ओम ने स्टडी किया। एंड व्हेन ही स्टडीड ही केम अक्रॉस अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द थिंग्स। ओके, नाउ व्हाट वाज इट दैट आई विल जस्ट शो इट टू विद अ स्मॉल एनिमेशन। आई थिंक आवर चिल्ड्रन विल रियली एंजॉय दिस, इज अगेन एन ओपन स्टैक्स वीडियो, इज इट विजिबल?
Yes.
Yeah. So here you can see that V is the potential difference, I is the current which is flowing in the circuit, it is small, and okay. R. I am presenting this video because this is an open source video. All the students can also just go to it, that is PHET, FET, we call it FET videos. and here you can change the things and see how with changing one other can change. Like, see what I have on my right hand side, that is V. So I can drag this and I can increase V. See, can you see?
Yes,
battery, it is increasing. Battery increase only. Okay.
Yes.
So you see the cell, we are having 1.5, that is 3 volts. So now this is the circuit. So now the potential which we have given difference is 3 volts. Okay. And this is the conductor resistance. Okay. This is the conductor across which it is given. In this whole situation, this resistance here is 500 ohm. Now this resistance will actually come, but I just want to show here that if I change the voltage, now see carefully what is happening to current. The current value is also increasing. You see it has become 16 milliamperes. Okay, so I'll just reduce the resistance little bit. Yeah, now you see when I'm increasing the voltage, when I'm decreasing the voltage, what is happening to I? I is also decreasing. When I'm increasing the voltage, the current is increasing, but you see resistance is same because this is that is related to this conductor. So I'm not changing anything in the conductor. Okay. So for this particular voltage and this particular value of current, these two are related. When the voltage is this and the resistance and the conductor is this, then this much current would flow through the conductor. Or when this is the current, then this much voltage potential difference will be there across the conductor. So by this, these kind of simulations, they are very interesting and children can do and they can enjoy these things very much. So I'll come back to my presentation. And here we can just see that. Now what did Ohm study? He studied that all these are related and he saw the circuit. Now this is the circuit which you saw just now. Like when we make a circuit, it will be like this. Circuit to study Ohm's law, we'll add many batteries, many cells into the circuit. So we'll bring in more and more cells. What will happen? If you bring in more and more cells, then you can increase the current. If you decrease the number of cells in the circuit, then the current will change accordingly. Now, what we'll do with the help of a voltmeter and with the help of an ammeter, as we all have studied, that the voltmeter will measure the potential difference across this load resistance R, and this ammeter will measure the current which is flowing through this circuit. We will note down what are the values. And when we note down these values, we'll find some relation between them. What was the relation? It was stated. The statement is that the potential difference across the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the current which flows through it, provided its temperature remains same. Means if you keep the temperature of a conductor constant, because temperature would vary some internal things in the conductor, so we need to keep the temperature constant, then what happens is that the potential difference across the ends of the conductor will be directly proportional to the current which is flowing through it. So jitna current jo potential difference hai wo directly related hai conductor mein kitna current flow kar raha hai usse. So it is a linear relationship. Matlab wo kya square ke hisab se vary kar raha hai ya inversely vary kar raha hai? नहीं, ये लीनियरली वेरी कर रहा है एंड इट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल. तो इसको अगर हम मैथमेटिकली लिखें तो ये आएगा V इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू I, दैट इज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द करंट. और जब हम मैथमेटिक्स में इस तरह की प्रोपोर्शनलिटी के कम अक्रॉस करते हैं, व्हेन वी कम अक्रॉस सच प्रोपोर्शनलिटी साइन, देन व्हाट वी डू इज दैट वी रिप्लेस द प्रोपोर्शनलिटी साइन विद एन इक्वल टू एंड अ कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शनलिटी. So these children will come across many times in various formulas, in writing various formulas. So V is proportional to I, or V by I is a constant. इस constant को हमने देखा ये क्या है, जब ओम ने ये पता करने की कोशिश की, ये constant जो है इसी को हम resistance कहते हैं. So that constant is nothing but the resistance of the conductor. So it is written that V by I, that is a constant, that is the voltage to the current ratio is always remaining a constant. Means if you draw a graph of voltage and current, then you will get a straight line. If you are not changing the temperature, if you are not changing the conductor, then voltage or current ki agar hum graph plot karenge, to it will be a straight line. I'll show you in the next slide. So V is equal to IR, and R is called as the resistance, and it is a constant for a given dimensions of a metallic wire. आप कितनी वायर लेते हैं, कितना कंडक्टर लेते हैं, उसके लिए एक पर्टिकुलर रेजिस्टेंस होती है. तो सो एक कंडक्टर जो है उसके लेंथ और उसके डायमेंशंस और व्हाट इट इज मेड अप ऑफ, दीज थिंग्स विल डिटरमिन द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंडक्टर. सो व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ करंट फ्लोइंग इन अ सर्किट, द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंडक्टर वुड मैटर. एंड दिस रेजिस्टेंस, व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ इट, इफ यू सी देन द यूनिट ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस विल बी वोल्ट डिवाइडेड बाय here volt divided by here current, current ka hai amperes or this is volt ohms. So resistance is volt per ohm, sorry it is a misprint here. So it is here, it is here, sorry ye m nahi hai, current is in amperes, okay a hona chahiye. So volt per ampere or ohm, which is isko hum log ohm kehte hain, ohm, and it is denoted by this Greek alphabet ohm. Okay, omega. Ohm is denoted by this omega, which you can see here. So this is Ohm's law. So the relation is very simple, that V is equal to I times R, that is current times resistance, or we can say the ratio of V by R is a constant. So that is Ohm's law. Now here children need to identify that this is a cause and effect relationship. मतलब जो voltage जो है उसके कारण से current बढ़ रहा है या कम. So with the voltage is the cause and the current is the effect, okay. So this is just an, it is like an, it is an empirical law, means you have to do an experiment to establish this relationship. It is an experimentally observed phenomena, Ohm's law. So this is a cause and effect relationship. Voltage jo hai wo hum ghata ya bada sakte hain, wo ek linear relationship, it is a linear relationship. Voltage drives the current, voltage badhate jao current badhega. And resistance impedes the current, means resistance jo hai wo agar badhayenge to current kamega. So resistance would decrease the current. Why? Because when you try to make more current move, then what is happening here, more collisions are taking place within the atoms. If there is more collision means if the resistance is high, then there will be more collisions, and then there will be heating, and there's some kind of transfer of energy will take place, and that will limit the current, that will decrease the current. That means if resistance is more, then the current would decrease, but if you increase the voltage, the current would increase. But again, for the same conductor, the ratio of the voltage and the current would remain a constant. That is Ohm's law.
Okay,
so current is inversely proportional to the resistance. So here this term resistance has come, and this resistance, what do we do about it? Now agar aapne ek particular length ka wire lete ho, copper, let us say we take a meter of a copper wire, it will have a particular value of resistance. You take 1.5 meter of the same wire, it will have a different value of resistance, because it would depend on the length. Jitni lambi hai wire, jitna lamba hai conductor, utna hi resistance uska badhega, because more electrons will be there, more collision, there will be more, the resistance will be more. Now, and it will also depend on the area of cross section of the conductor, because the greater is the area of cross section, the easily the electrons are able to move. So it depends on the length of the conductor, it depends on the area of cross section of the conductor, and it depends on the material of the conductor. What is that conductor made up of? Is it copper, is it aluminium, is it silver, is it any other thing which conducts very less? So what material is it, on that also it depends. So what we are doing is that we want to relate this resistance to property of that material. Matlab us copper ka kuch ek hum aisa cheez define kare jo copper ke liye hi specific ho, and it should be related to the resistance, and that we are calling it as resistivity. So what we say, that resistance is proportional to length, okay, inversely proportional to area,
okay,
and so we are again putting a constant of proportionality, which we are calling as rho, and rho is called as the resistivity. And resistivity is a quality of the material which you are using. So copper, all copper wires of a particular type will have a particular resistivity, all aluminium wires will have one resistivity. So we have related that to resistivity. I put some values for that. So this is the same thing which I have put in the mathematical form. Resistance is proportional to the length of the conductor. Resistance is inversely proportional to the cross section area. And if you combine, then replacing the proportionality constant with rho, that is called as a resistivity, that is a quality of the material, of the conducting material which we are using. And here there are some values. Now you see very, you can see here that okay. The good conductors will have a very high resistivity. You can see here,
1.6.
Good conductors will have very low resistivity, and insulators will have a very high resistivity because insulators don't allow current to pass. So you can see the values here, 1.6 into 10 to the minus 8. So silver is a very good conductor. Whereas if you come to, you go lower and you come to this glass and all, which are not conductors at all. So 10 to the power 10. So resistivity is so high. So by looking at the resistivity of a particular material, you can tell whether it's a good conductor or whether it's an insulator or what. So usually alloys are also conductors, but their resistivity is higher than the conductors. So alloys are there. So when we want to use something for resistance, that can be used alloys like constantin, magnanin. So these are used for giving resistance. Whereas these silver, copper, aluminium, these are used for conduction. So by looking at the resistivity of a material, we can tell whether that material is a good conductor or an insulator. So that is about resistivity. I have just to explain that relation of current and voltage, I have taken a small problem, that is how much current will an electric heater draw from a source of 220 volt if the resistance of that is 1200 ohms. So agar 1200 ohm resistance hai, so how much current will it draw from a 220 volt? Usually 220 volts we have as a our power supply in our houses. So agar hum ek aisa appliance use kare jiska resistance 1200 ohms hai, to kitne current draw karti hai? So it is drawing 0.18 here amperes of current. Okay. And same thing, if you take another one which has got a low resistance, we are having here the filament, we are having V is equal to IR, okay? So there if you see, it will be I will be equal to V by R. So V by R will be 2.2 ampere. So here we can note what is the difference between the current which is drawn when an electric bulb is there and when an electric heater is there. So there is a quite amount of difference because V is equal to IR, and so V by R will be equal to I. So if R becomes very, very large, then the current which is there in the circuit, that is very small. And when R is low, then the current is more in the circuit. So this difference we can see from this example.
Okay.
Rahul ji, how much time we are left with?
We have 10 minutes, 10 to 8.
Okay, fine. So I can just take up this where I can explain to the students resistance of system of resistors. Now see, when we are actually using this electricity in factories, anywhere, that time using many appliances to run this, many appliances are run with electricity. So actually, what are these appliances? These appliances are nothing but the loads, isn't it? If you aap ek motor chala rahe electricity laga ke, to wo motor jo hai wo ek load hai, aur usko hum ek resistance ke hisab se dekhte hain, theek hai? To jaise hamare ghar mein bahut sare appliances lage hote hain, hai na? Hamare ghar mein fridge hoti hai, TV hoti hai, bulbs hote hain, air conditioner hai, bahut sare, aur ek hi circuit mein sare joined hote hain, hai na?
Yes.
So what we need to know is that when we connect different resistances in a circuit, then how to calculate or how to find out that how much current is going through a particular appliance? Hai na, ek fridge ke liye jo current ki zarurat hai, wo ek bulb se alag hai. Ek heater ko chalane ke liye jo jitna current chahiye, wo ek bulb se alag hai. Lekin hamara jo power house ka jo power supply hai, wo 220 to 240 volts ke andar hoti hai. So ek voltage hume diya hai. उसके अंदर हमें ये सारे अप्लायंस ऑपरेट करने होते हैं. वी हैव टू ऑपरेट सो मेनी अप्लायंसेस. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज दैट वी कनेक्ट दीज इन द सर्किट इन आवर हाउस होल्ड. बट वी नीड टू नो दैट हाउ मच करेंट इज विच इज ड्रॉइंग हाउ मच करंट. सो इफ यू हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट रेजिस्टेंसेज कनेक्टेड इन अ सर्किट देन हाउ डू यू नो दैट वॉट इज द टोटल रेजिस्टेंस विच इज एक्टिंग इन द सर्किट. सो बेसिकली वी आर हैविंग टू टाइप्स ऑफ अरेंजमेंट. One is a series arrangement and one is a parallel arrangement. These are the two basic types of arrangement we have. Now, what is a series? This, the left-hand side, what you can see, that is a series arrangement. That is, the resistances are just joined end to end. Ek resistance ka ek end is joined to the first end of the other resistor. Then the second resistor's end is joined to the next resistor's first end. So like this, if you keep on joining one after the other, this is called as joining the resistances in series. And if you join all the ends of one resistor at one point and the other end at another point, like you see on my right hand side, that is called as a parallel connection or a parallel series, that is a resistors which are connected in parallel. So two systems we have, series and parallel. So in this series and parallel, we just want to know कि अगर ऐसे अगर चार resistance हमने जोड़ दिए तो total कितना है और उन्हीं चारों को अगर इस तरह से जोड़ा जाए तो total resistance और effective resistance कितना है. We want to know that. And Ohm's law will very easy help us to find out how much it is. And with a lot of ease we can find out. So I've tried to show you that how we can make a circuit. Like we have three resistances. So we have a voltmeter, we have an ammeter, we have a battery which is driving the circuit. So when it is series, I have taken three resistances here. So what is the difference which is happening in series and what is in parallel? We'll see that. Now when you are having a series arrangement, and this is called as a parallel arrangement. If you do in parallel, then all the ends of one resistors are at one end. One end of all the resistors are at one point. And the other end of all the resistors are connected at another point.
Okay.
So this is called as a parallel resistor, parallel combination. Okay. So this is how we connect the circuit. Now what we'll try to do is that we'll try to find out that ये इसका equivalent क्या होता है? अगर तीन resistors को ऐसे लगाया जाए और तीन resistors को ऐसे लगाया जाए, are they same?
ठीक
है. No, they are not same. So how much it is? So we'll find out and very easily we can do with an Ohm's law.
Okay.
So what we'll do? We will measure the voltage across when they are connected in series. Then what will happen? The current through all of them will be same. क्योंकि देखिए यहाँ जो current move कर रही है circuit में वो एक ही current पूरे circuit में move करेगी, same current. So in all through R1, through R2, through R3, the same current is flowing. Whereas the voltage drop across the resistances will be different. यहाँ पे जो voltage drop across R1 let us say V1, voltage drop across R2, let us say it is V2, voltage drop across R3, let us say it is V3. Ye V1 plus V2 plus V3 total will be the voltage which you have provided across the three resistances. So yahan pe jo hai voltage divide ho jati hai but current remains same in the circuit. So through R1, R2 and R3 the current flowing is same. So what happens because of that is ki we are having V1, the voltage drop across this resistance R1, we'll have it as, or we can say voltage drop across the resistance R1 is, we can say current times resistance. So IR1. Voltage drop across R2 is current times resistance, that is R2, IR2. Similarly, voltage drop across the third resistance R3 is VI3. If you add these three equations, we get that V1 plus V2 plus V3 is IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. And if you simplify it, you will get that V is equal to I times R1 plus R2 plus R3. So what is this V and what is this I? If you take V by I, then this V by I is nothing but the effective resistance, because Ohm's law is telling V is equal to IR. So what is this V? V is the total current, total voltage. I is the total current flowing the circuit. So what is R? R is the effective resistance. So that means the effective resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So when is it? When the current flowing in the circuit is in such a way that the same current flows. When the same current will flow? when all the resistance are in series. Same thing we can, so this is a formula that when the resistances are connected in series, then their net resistance or the effective resistance is the sum of the individual resistances. So R1 plus R2 plus R3, very simple. Same way if you connect in parallel, then what remains same? Like in the previous one, current was remaining same, voltage was getting divided. Here, current is getting divided in the three resistances. You see, in this, suppose I1 will flow, in this I2, in this, let us say I3. Then all the three combined, I1 plus I2 plus I3 together, that will be the total current in the circuit. So okay. We are using this and using Ohm's law in the similar way, I can write what is I1. I1 will be equal to V by R1 because the voltage drop across all these three will be same. They are connected across the same voltage. Inke sare ends, tino ke ends jo hai, ek particular battery ke across connected hai. To inko tino ko same voltage ke.
Okay. तो ये जो इस वक्त ओम्स लॉ के एक्सपेरिमेंट्स यहाँ पर आप देख रहे थे, ये आपको अपने घर में भी पढ़ने होंगे और जाहिर सी बात है कि इनको समझा आसानी से जा सकता है. हमारा ये जो सेशन है इसे आप YouTube पर भी देख पाएंगे बाद में, NCERT के ऑफिशियल YouTube चैनल पर. जी गौरी जी, आप मेरी आवाज़ सुन पा रही हैं?
जी हाँ जी हाँ राहुल जी, बीच में थोड़ा सिग्नल ये हो गया, ड्रॉप हो गया था.
जी जी
जी हाँ, इट इज अबाउट टू कंक्लूड आल्सो.
जी
या so we are having this I1 plus I2 plus I3 and that is a total current in the circuit and V is equal to, if you see that, then we get I by V is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 which is nothing but I by V is nothing but 1 by RP, that is the effective resistance in parallel. So when they are connected in parallel, then we have 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 if there are four resistances connected in parallel, plus 1 by R4 and n number of resistances be connected honge, toh the same formula goes on. So 1 by RP means 1 by effective resistance in parallel. So when you have such a combination in parallel, then this is the formula which gives you the effective resistance of the effective resistance when some resistance are connected in parallel. So this is what I wanted to tell the students in this session.
Okay.
That when we have such kind of combination of resistance, what is the effective resistance? That means we can see here when resistances are connected in parallel, mm-hmm. then net resistance will decrease. And when the resistance are connected in series, then the net resistance becomes the sum of the individual resistances. So this is a series and a parallel combination of resistance. And we have seen that what is the equivalent resistance, and we have also learned today about what is Ohm's law, what is the statement of Ohm's law,
right.
And what kind of relationship exists between voltage and current. And
जी, वोल्टेज और करंट का जो रिलेशनशिप है वो भी यहाँ समझना होगा. और तो गौरी जी, क्या ये हम कह सकते हैं कि आज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का पार्ट थ्री जो हमने किया तो ये चैप्टर कंक्लूड हो गया है? क्योंकि
जी नहीं, क्योंकि
जी बहरहाल हम अपना ये सेशन यहीं समाप्त करने वाले हैं क्योंकि हमारा ये समय भी पूरा हो रहा है. और आपने इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पार्ट थ्री आज पढ़ा, पार्ट वन और पार्ट टू आप पहले पढ़ चुके हैं. तो इन तीनों पार्ट्स को आप एक साथ देखेंगे तो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का जो कंसेप्ट है वो घर में बैठे बैठे ही आपका क्लियर हो जाएगा. आप हमारा आज का ये सेशन YouTube पर बाद में देख पाएंगे. और मैं आपसे अपनी टीम के साथ विदा लेता हूँ. थोड़ी ही देर में हम फिर हाजिर होंगे हिंदी का सत्र लेकर. कहीं मत जाइएगा, कक्षा दसवीं का हमारा अगला सत्र है. अभी हाजिर होते हैं, थोड़ी ही देर में देखते रहिए PME विद्या चैनल्स. नमस्कार.